Hello everyone, welcome back to Learn Khmer with my channel and I'm Dara from the Khmer Lesson. I hope everyone is good and today I have a new video for you. And in this video, everyone will learn 15 verbs from letter F, include examples as well. Okay, right now if you are ready, let's get started with me together. But the first word is the word fail. Fail. Thlẹt. Thlẹt. Example. She failed the exam. She failed the exam. Niêng ban thlẹt ka prolong. Niêng ban thlẹt ka prolong. Ba thlẹt is the word fail, and then when you use like in past tense, you can add ban thlẹt, và ban thlẹt fail with ed nè. And ka prolong is exam, và exam is a noun. Niêng ban thlẹt ka prolong. Fall, và fall there are two meaning. Okay, number one you say thlẹt as well like the word fail, và thlẹt. Example. Does the rain fall there? Does the rain fall there? Tí nu phliêng thlẹt tê. Tí nu phliêng thlẹt tê. Ba, tí nu is mean there. Okay, I use first at the beginning of the sentence. I use tí nu phliêng, ba, it means rain. Rain, phliêng, and thlẹt is fall. Okay, and his tê is a question word. Ba, again, tí nu phliêng thlẹt tê. And second meaning, fall also, but we say dul. But dul, mostly we focus on people, or mostly people. Like example, you say, if he walks, he will fall. If he walks, he will fall. Ba kot da kot nung dul. Ba kot da kot nung dul. You see, ba. So ba I mean if, and God you know I mean he or she. Da is walk. Dul is fall, and nung is future. Then you say nung for will. Okay, ba. Again, ba God da, God nung dul. Ba. Next word is the word fit. There are two meaning as well. Number one focus on person, ba. So fit when you focus on person, we say bánh chọc, bánh chọc. Và for example, I'm feeding my kid. I'm feeding my kid. Khnhom cầm bông bánh chọc côn khnhom. Khnhom cầm bông bánh chọc côn khnhom. Và this sentence I use present continue because I'm feeding my kid. So you know already when you use present continue in Khmer, you use cầm bông before verb. Ba. So I say cầm bông bánh chọc, it means feeding. And con it mean it means kid. Con khnhom it means my kid. Ba. Again, khnhom cầm bông bánh chọc con khnhom. Ba. And second meaning of the word feed. Okay, and mostly focus on animal. Ba, animal. That in Khmer you say đặt mà hộp. Đặt mà hộp. That by itself I mean put, and my hope is food, right? So I mean put food, put food. So we mostly we focus on animal. Now let's see the example. You say, don't forget to feed the dog. Don't forget to feed the dog. Complete that my hope sky. Complete that my hope sky. But this is a negative for comment, and then you use done at the beginning, and in Khmer you say gom at the end, no te. But remember this this point, but gom something something, and then exclamatory sentence. But okay, ta complete that mà hộp chai. But plek it means forget, forget. So when you say don't forget, complete, complete. But and chai is dog, but chai. So you say again, complete that mà hope chạy. Next word is the word feel. Và feel mean arom. Mean arom. For example, I feel sad. I feel sad. Khnyom mean arom pi bạc chật. Khnyom mean arom pi bạc chật. Và pi bạc chật is sad. Và sad. Khnyom mean arom pi bạc chật. Okay. To fight. Và to fight. Why? Actually, for the word to fight in writing, we write vay. Vay. But in spoken, we always say why. So I decide to use why because it's easier to say why. Why? Và. Example. I don't want to fight you. I don't want to fight you. Khnyom ot chong vay nea te. Khnyom ot chong vay nea te. Ba. So, ba chong, you know, I mean want to. Ba. Chẳng, you say khnyom ot chong vay nea te. Next word is the word find. Ba, find. Rơ khơn. Rơ khơn. Ba. For example, if you try, you will find it. If you try, you will find it. Bà nè chìa diếm, nè nâng rơ khơi vỉa. Bà nè chìa diếm, nè nâng rơ khơi vỉa. Ok, bà bảo you know what I mean if. Chìa diếm is the word to try. Try, bà, and nè nâng rơ khơi, bà rơ khơi is the word, find, nha, bà. Again, bà nè chìa diếm, nè nâng rơ khơi vỉa. Finish. Và finish, there are two meaning. First one is no object. Và it means after finish is not an object. Và. So in this case, the word to finish, you say job. I know most students always know this meaning, that they always say job all the time. Và. But it's correct when you use without object. For example, my class finish at 2 o'clock. My class finish at 2 o'clock. Thnak khnyom chop maung pi. Thnak khnyom chop maung pi. You see, after finish is not anything else, but just at 2 o'clock. But, so this is like how to translate finish without object. Nah? But you say chop. Okay, let's learn some word from this sentence. But thnak, it means class. Class. Nah? Thnak. And mount P is 2 o'clock. Ba, 2 o'clock. Now let's say again. Thnak khnyom chop mount P. Ba. And now look at second meaning with object. Ba, finish something. Finish something. In this case, you say bành chop. Bành chop. Ba. So you see, this is difference between finish chop and finish bành chop. Eh? Now let's see example. I will finish it by today. I will finish it by today. So it as an is an object, right? Finish something, finish it, finish my work, something like that. But I will finish it by today. Khnyom nâng bành chọc vỉa trăm ngày nì. Khnyom nâng bành chọc vỉa trăm ngày nì. But so you see, you say bành chọc. And trăm ngày nì, I mean by today. When you use by plus time, like by this week, by today, by 2 o'clock, by this month, but by in this case, you say trăm. Trăm, na? Trăm ngày nì. Again, khnyom nâng bành chọc vía trăm ngày nì. Ba. Fit. Ba. Fit. Trâu. Trâu is the same as the word must or have to. Now we say trâu as well. But then it fit your body. Bah. Example. This shirt doesn't fit me. This shirt doesn't fit me. Áo ni ọt trâu khnyom tê. Áo ni ọt trâu khnyom tê. Bah. maybe it's too small, it's too big, but so it doesn't fit me, eh? But L ni ot trai khyom te. Fly. Ha. Ha. Now let's see example. This airplane will fly to Cambodia. This airplane will fly to Cambodia. Yun ha ni nang ha tau Cambodia. Yun ha ni nang ha tau Cambodia. Ba, so you see the word yun ha is airplane. Ba, airplane. So ha it means to fly. To fly. Ba. So yun ha ni nang ha tau Cambodia. Fold. Ba, to fold. Bot. Bot. It's the same as the word to turn when you say turn left, turn right. Nah? Okay, you say bot also. And this one, you fold paper, you fold something else. But for example, please fold this paper in two. Please fold this paper in two. But into part. Okay. Som bot krodah ni chia pi. Som bot krodah ni chia pi. But it means fold, and krodah is paper. Paper, a paper, right? Paper. But, and GP, it means into parts. But into parts, GP. Yeah. So, bot krodah ni GP. Follow. Follow. Tam. Tam. For example, he follows me all the time. He follows me all the time. God tam khnyom krup pel. God tam khnyom krup pel. Ba, so tam is follow. And krup pel, I mean all the time. Krup pel. All the time. Ba. Now, let's say again. God tam khnyom krup pel. Forbid. Forbid. Ham quad. Ham quad. For example, you have no right to forbid me. You have no right to forbid me. Neak ot mean sit. Ham quad khnyom ti. Neak ot mean sit. Ham quad khnyom ti. But the word sit is right. Human right. Sit manu. But right to do something. Okay. So ot mean sit, it means have no right. You have no right. But ham court is forbid. Again. Ne ot mean sit ham court khnyom te. Forget. There are two meanings as well. Number one, no purpose. It means you don't have any purpose to forget something. Just no intention, right? But so in this case, you say plek. Everyone know this word already. We say plek. Plek. Okay, now let's see example. I always forget my book. I always forget my book. So you see, I don't have any purpose to forget it. But yeah, I forget. In Khmer, you say khnyom tang tai. Ba tang tai is the word always. Plek siu phơ khnyom. Khnyom tang tai plek siu phơ khnyom. Ba siu phơ, you know, I mean book. Ba so siu phơ khnyom, my book. I always forget my book. Khnyom tang tai plek siu phơ khnyom. Ba. And second meaning, it means you have purpose to forget something. It means like you try to forget someone. Okay. Ba so in this case, you say bom plek. Yeah. Bom plek, ba, forget someone, forget something. Let's see example. I try to forget her. I try to forget her. Khnyom pchia yim bom plek niang. Khnyom pchia yim bom plek niang. But in this way, without the word her, okay, that you know already, you can say got. But now I would like to use niang. Okay, I try to forget her. Khnyom pchia yim, but it means to try. Nhóm chia diêm bầm phịch niềng. Bà, you see? Bà. Forgive. Lực lên tù. Or another option like shorter than this, you just say lực lên. Bà, lực lên tù. You can skip, no problem. Bà. So now I read the full word. I say lực lên tù. Bà, lực lên tù. For example, can you forgive me? Bà, can you forgive me? Nè lực lên tù nhóm bàn tế. Nè lực lên tù nhóm bàn tế. Bà, so this is a question of can. So you use bàn tế. Bà. But the last word is the word freeze. Bà, freeze. Có. Có. Bah, so this is the word freeze. Nah? When you hear this word, maybe you think about the word ice, right? Ice is tekko, and tek is water. Tekko is frozen water. That in Thai we say tekko. Nah? Bah. Now let's see example. The water freeze. I'm not sure you read freeze or freezes in winter, but maybe freezes. The water freezes in winter. Tất cọ. Okay, I have a space here. Nah? Because when if I didn't write space, maybe some students they confuse with the word tất cọ, ice. Because tất cọ we write together without space. Nah? Tất cọ. But this one we say tất cọ. I mean the water is frozen. Nah? Và tất cọ nơi rồi đâu rồi nghĩa. Tất cọ no rodau rongi. Ba, so I mean water frozen in winter. Ba, winter is rodau rongi. It means cold season. Okay, now again. Tất có no rodau rongi. Ba, that's all for this lesson. I hope everyone enjoyed this. And also, I think this lesson is useful for everyone. Ba, as usual, if you are not clear or don't understand or have any idea from this video, please let me know and I will try to answer your question. Bye. Okay, again, thanks so much for watching and see you in the next video. Bye bye.